route. We're right here at the corner of Ridgewood Road and Old Canton, 5000 Ridgewood Road, the Pearl Apartments. We have a barricaded suspect inside of one of the apartments. He was wanted by JPD for kidnapping and also several other misdemeanor warrants, 4 domestic violence warrants, 3 simple assault warrants, and the one that the U.S. Marshals was here about, the kidnapping warrant from the Jackson Police Department. A young lady who was inside the apartment fled the apartment. She advised our team that he was inside the apartment armed with an assault rifle. That's the initial information that we have. He has been non-compliant. He is refusing contact with law enforcement at this particular time. We have our hostage negotiators on scene attempting to make contact with him. And of course, we have our SWAT team on scene as well. I want to thank Hinds County. I want to thank Capitol Police Department for also being out here today. We're going to do our best to resolve this situation and mitigate it without anybody being hurt or loss of life. But we're actively attempting to apprehend Mr. Jarrell Lynch. Jarrell Lynch, 27 years of age. He currently has 7 misdemeanor warrants and a felony kidnapping warrant here at this location today. I'm open for any questions.
Chief, have you guys, obviously, I'd imagine you've evacuated the unit surrounding this complex where he lives?
Yes, we've spoken with the manager. We've informed her of the time frame and what we're looking for, and also any other ingress and egress points here at the apartment complex. We recommend that her tenants use those. But also, if you have no reason to be here, don't come out here sightseeing. You know, this individual is armed with an assault rifle. We have a large law enforcement presence here. We want to make sure that everyone is safe. We've also reached out to Jackson Academy, which is next door. We'll also be speaking to them again because we have kids here. We have people that's in the park. We have a lot of people driving by this location. We do not want anybody to get hurt or injured. Our goal is to mitigate this situation without any loss of life or injury. And that's what we're working on doing right now. I want to make sure everybody's informed. That's why I'm talking right now to the public. Stay out of this area if you do not necessarily need to be in this particular area.
How long have officers been on scene?
Probably about an hour. It is hard to guesstimate when you have a large scale event like this. It's very fluid, it's very active. We're doing our best just to make contact with him. Hey, come out. Come out. Let the criminal justice system take its course. There's no need you to get hurt, any of these police officers to get hurt, or some innocent person in the area to get hurt. So we're trying to mitigate it as best we can without loss of life, but we do not want any innocent person getting hurt. So stay out of this area if you have no reason to be over here.
And the victim that he allegedly kidnapped, that would not be the same young woman that left the apartment, would it?
No, and that was my question too when I came out, because if it is, then that's a wash. But it's not. There's another victim, and I don't want to divulge who that is at this particular time, but we have a active kidnapping warrant for him that was attempted to be served upon him by the U.S. Marshals along with our JPD U.S. Marshals Task Force officer, and he refused to be compliant. She fled out. He ran upstairs, supposedly armed with an assault rifle.
And the victim that he allegedly kidnapped, is that person safe?
Yes, that person is not on scene. That person is not here, and we'll divulge who that is at a later time.